Hi, my name is Gary Eckstein and I'm from organicweb.com.au. I'm a Mailchimp Pro partner and, well, most of all, I'm just one of those weird people that just loves marketing. I often get asked in my marketing lectures and classes what people can do to improve their copywriting or how they should add copy to emails, what they should add to emails. Well, fortunately, there's a very good copywriting formula that I certainly use because I'm no good at copywriting that seems to work very, very well. The formula is called AIDA, and it's actually very old, from the late 1800s by someone called Elias St. Elmo Lewis. He originally came up with this, and the AIDA copywriting formula stands for attention, interest, desire, and action. And I'll show how this is used in a second. This can be used for the buyer's journey if you want to map the buyer's journey. First people you get their attention, then they're interested in your product, you create desire for them to buy, and then they take action, they buy. But as a copywriting formula, it works incredibly well, not just for email marketing, but for advertising, for social media posts on Facebook, on Instagram, whatever. So we'll look very quickly at how do we map the AIDA formula to our email marketing itself. So the attention part is the subject line. The interest part is the header, and I will show you some examples in a second. The desire is the body text, and the action is the button or the call to action. Okay, so we create a nice, compelling subject line. Often a question works well, but what we're trying to do in the subject line is we're trying to get the person to open the email to read more, where they'll see the interest, desire, and then take the action by clicking. So the subject line really needs to compel the person again to open the email to read more, but it really has to. The subject line must convey the benefits of the consumer opening the email. So it has to align with your content, your interest and your desire and your action. So your interest is your header, your desire is your body text, and action is a call to action. Now, something I show in all my workshops and so on is on the action, the call to action. And I always say to people, just looking at this image, and look, I took this photograph. I live in Brisbane, Australia, and I went for a run around the local neighborhood. This is actually a few years old now, but there was construction happening at a house, and I looked across and I saw that this, what we call a ute or a pickup, if you call it that, or whatever you call it, this vehicle was for sale. Now, it had a sign on the front of the car saying for sale, as you can see, and on the side, in the side window, it had a nice big for sale sign, and that's just wonderful, right? Because they've got my attention. But how do you buy the car? Where's the telephone number or whatever? And this is how important it is that, yes, we can get the person's attention, but if we don't tell them what to do, give them that call to action, the button, we've lost the sale. So all of these parts are incredibly important. So let's look at these various bits, AIDA, attention, interest, desire, action. Let's look at them. So let's look at Pepsi. So they've got So the subject line, they would have a subject line, which is, the subject line is the attention. Then they get our interest, that's what I like. And they actually have that twice, or two different interests, which is absolutely fine. Time to tell the world, that's what I like. Going back to that, so that's attention, the subject line, interest is the header, desire. There's the desire. They explain it a little bit more and whet your appetite or the reader's appetite a little more. And then there's the action. Nice and simple. So header, just a little bit of text that feeds on from that header, and then tell the person what to do. Watch the video. Let's look at Uber very quickly. Very similar layout. So we would have our subject line, which would be the attention. They have a nice subject line, which encourages me to open the email itself. Interest, desire, action. Let's look at that. So we've got interest, desire, the body, they explain a bit more, and the action, try it today. So very typical formula. Now you'll see this again and again and again, and the AIDA formula, although it was developed back in the late 1800s, it's still used, and it's used successfully by many organizations. Here's Uber, Pepsi, you'll notice it in Disney, many other organizations. And if you have more than one story, in other words, you have a newsletter or just more than one story, you would just keep repeating that formula. So you'd keep repeating the, okay, your attention is your subject line, you'll only have one of those. You would then have interest, desire, action, next story. Interest, desire, action, next story. Interest, desire, action, nice and easy. So again, that was Uber, but let's look at it mapped across. So you can see on this image that I've mapped it. That's your interest, is your header. Your desire is a little bit more information. And down the bottom, you can see the action is to take action, to click on something. So we're giving people something firm to do so that they know exactly what to do to buy the goods or whatever the case might be. In Mailchimp, fortunately, they make it incredibly simple. So I'm in the Mailchimp, the new builder, email builder in Mailchimp. So again, attention, interest, desire, action. We would get our interest by setting a subject line. And if I go into design email, we'll just wait a second. You'll notice that the elements are already there. Interest, we can add some desire, and action. So Mailchimp automatically include the AIDA principles for us. Now, obviously, you do need to fill in the various attention, interest, desire, action. And just as we saw on Uber, Pepsi, etc. So our subject line, I've already spoken about. Short, sharp, sweet. Question often works well. It has to convey the benefit of the person opening the email. So our interest is a nice big header. So that'll just be a few words as a heading. Desire is a little bit more of an explanation about, about the interest and the attention. And then the action is a nice big pink, green, blue button, whatever, that a person can click to buy the product or whatever. So this old formula, AIDA formula, works extremely well. Again, for email marketing, for advertising, for social media and so on. Nice and simple, you can do it. Give it a go and you'll see how easy it is. But thanks for joining me. I'm Gary from organicweb.com.au.